Whoop! I see you. I see you right here. You clicked into this video meaning gising ka pa at busy ka pa sa pag-scroll ng feed mo sa Facebook, sa Twitter, sa Instagram, and of course, sa YouTube. Because maybe you found this video at the middle of the night while you are struggling to fall asleep and ngayon napadpad ka sa video ko. And I'm sorry, but this is your sign that you must sleep right now. So, ito yung pinaka natandaan ko sa biopsychology naming subject back in college. Sleep deprivation can cause death faster than food deprivation. You can go on a diet or a keto diet or kahit hindi ka kumain ng anything solid for a week and yet you'll still be alive and kicking. But if you deprive yourself from sleeping for 1 week straight, tingnan mo ang magiging epekto nun sa'yo. Wait, I am not saying that you should try that. That might be very dangerous. Please, no. No, please, no. So again, the things that I will be saying here will not guarantee a cure or full recovery from the sleeplessness that you are experiencing or from the insomnia that you are experiencing. These are just the things that you can initially do to combat sleeplessness, but not insomnia. Because insomnia is a mental health disorder already. Kapag nakakaranas na kayo ng sleeplessness for 1 or 2 weeks na persistent, yung inyong hindi kayo makatulog, please seek a professional help already because this video will not help you for that. So without further ado, let's head right into the first aids that you can do to combat sleeplessness. So first aid that you can do to combat sleeplessness is to not force yourself to fall asleep. Okay, counteract your cognition, counteract your psyche. The more na sabihin niyo sa sarili niyo na at this certain time tutulog na ako, but turns out alas tres na hindi ka pa nakakatulog. Okay, let things happen smoothly. Okay, yung analysis na may isip ko lang dyan is halimbawa may mga tao kasi na the more na inuutusan mo sila, the more na parang ayaw nilang gawin ng isang bagay. Okay, so ganun lang din sa pagtulog. The more na sabihin mo sa utak mo na matutulog ka at this certain time, the more na hindi ka makakatulog. So please, do not force yourself to fall asleep. Kasi mape-pressure ka. You'll feel the pressure in yourself. And the more pressure you feel in yourself, the more sleepless you'll get. Second first aid is to turn off your lights. Bakit? Bakit? Anong connect? Bakit kailangan patayin ang ilaw? So this is the scientific explanation for that. We have the hormone called melatonin or the Dracula hormone. So, ito yung sinisecrete ng ating brain to induce sleep in our system. Kaya tayo nakakaramdam ng drowsiness, nagbibigat na yung mata natin. It is because nagsignal na ang hormone na melatonin. Kaya yun, nagkakaroon tayo ng symptoms of sleep. Okay? And the catch here is, melatonin is only activated if the lights are off. Hence the name Dracula hormone. So, please, if you are used to sleep na bukas ang ilaw and ngayon you are having a hard time falling asleep because you keep your lights on habang tulog ka hanggang sa madaling araw, hanggang sa magising ka na, please try to turn off your lights. Okay? So that your melatonin can be excreted at the right time. Third first aid is to turn on the ventilation in your room. Because those people who have difficulty in falling asleep have high body temperatures. Napansin ito ng isa kong friend na lumapit sa akin because he was having a hard time falling asleep. So I recommended him to turn on the ventilation in his room. So sabi niya sa akin, oo nga no, napansin ko sa sarili ko na parang yung katawan ko ay napapawisan para nakakaramdam ako ng init sa katawan. Kapag ganun, pag halimbawa naka-electric fan ka or kaya naka-aircon ka, please wag mo na ikaw magkumot kasi that might increase your body temperature. So, the first thing that you need to do is to let the breeze embrace your body first. Huwag ka munang magkumot pag unang minutes ng pagka-on mo ng ventilation. Para makatulong ito sa pag-cool down ng iyong body temperature. So, you can do that as well. fourth first aid that you can do is to breathe. Inhale. Exhale. In nasal inhalation. And then, exhale slowly but surely and mouth exhalation siya. So, okay, do that 3 times in a row. And that might help you because it helped me somehow. It helped me calm my mind. It helps you in calming yourself and in calming your body and your mind. Okay, so if you find yourself sleepless, please do the breathing exercise for 3 times. Okay? Fifth and final first aid that you can do to your sleeplessness is to a yoga. Okay, so ito, netong lockdown ko lang siya na experience because I've experienced a lot of sleepless nights during this COVID-19 season. So, ito, tinry ko siya. If I can no longer do this 4 first aids that I know, dagdagan ko ng isa, which is yoga. And manapakadami nito sa YouTube. Yung stretching and the breathing, alam mo, it helped me calm my mind kasi napakadami kong iniisip during this pandemic. Parang na-release ko yung aking iniisip during that time. And ang sarap ng tulog ko. It's effective for me, okay? You can also try that if you cannot fall asleep. Do a yoga before falling asleep. So those are the first aids that you can do to combat sleeplessness. But then again, I would like to repeat that those are just first aids. It cannot guarantee you a cure or a full recovery from your sleeplessness. And if that sleeplessness persists for 1 week or 2 weeks, please do not rely on this video anymore. This will not help you any longer because that means you already need a medical attention. Message ko rin to sa sarili ko actually because I deprive myself from sleeping because napakadaming bagay that keep me from sleeping. Netflix, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. Napakadami niyan. And I know you feel me, guys. I know you feel me. You don't need to deny it. But this is a message for you and me to get enough sleep because sleep is life. Okay? And that's it for this video. I know this video is just very short compared to my other videos, but ito na talaga yung video ko. And please know that we are all in this together. You are not alone. You are not experiencing this all alone. And together, we will combat this, okay? So, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode of Let's Talk About It.